The federal government is offering independent schools $3 billion to get students back to class. But principals say they're under pressure, forced to choose which advice to follow. Stephanie Anderson explains.
It took a lot of heavy lifting to empty these classrooms. Now Jim Lawson is being offered millions of dollars to bring everyone back.
Do you feel like you're being bribed?
Yes. It's not fair in a time like this.
The federal government is dangling the $3 billion carrot, promising independent schools an advance on funding in exchange for reopening their classrooms within weeks. Here in Victoria, it just escalates the political schoolyard stoush, with authorities still ordering the gates stay closed.
Expert health advice, not money, should determine whether or not a school fully opens for students, staff and teachers.
We've seen outstanding leadership in South Australia, in Western Australia and the Northern Territory where they've done this. And what we're trying to encourage is all other states and territories to follow suit.
The payments would give independent schools early access to up to a quarter of their annual funding, with principals required to sign up by this Friday to a plan to completely reopen their schools in term two, ensuring they're eligible for the first instalment. They must have 50% of students physically back in the classroom by June 1 to secure the second.
I'd love to be back at school on June the 1st, but I'm not going to risk the safety of my staff in particular.
While the state government is still directing students to learn from home for all of term two, the Education Minister has confirmed that work is being done behind the scenes to map out what's needed to get kids back into the classroom.
We won't go from 97%, more than 97% of students learning from home to bang every single student at school.
Stephanie Anderson, Nine News.